Hi everyone. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a responsive rotating slider using vanilla JavaScript and CSS. We also have a background animation with a snowfall effect using Particles.js. Let's dive into how it works. First, let's look at the HTML structure. Now we're adding a CDN to get font awesome icons. There is a main element holding the slider. It contains a previous and next button for navigation and several slides. Each slide has an image and a caption. Now let's move on to CSS. First, I import Google Fonts. I prefer Cabin Font for the text. We reset margins and padding. We set a radial gradient background with a smooth transition from deep blue to dark navy. We use Flexbox to center the slider vertically and horizontally in the main element. This class ensures full screen responsiveness with centered content. Each slide has a centered layout and cannot be interacted with directly. It adds a semi-transparent overlay with a blur effect, enhancing the visual depth of each slide. This element is styled with a bold white font. For now, it is visible on all slides, but then we will add an animation to make it visible for only the active slide. The control buttons have a circular and semi-transparent appearance, enhanced by animations for color and size changes. After the JavaScript functions, we will turn here for the keyframes of these animations. When hovering over control button, its background changes and all animations are disabled. The control buttons are positioned on the left and right sides. On hover, active control buttons tilt and scale dynamically for an interactive effect. By the way, disabled buttons will remain static. Now, we add the media queries to make the slider responsive. For smaller screens, control buttons will be repositioned depending on the center. We also scale down the slide width and font sizes proportionally to maintain usability and visual appeal. First, we select all the slide and navigation buttons with Query Selector. The active index represents the currently active slide by dividing the total number of slides by 2. This way, the initial active slide is set to the middle of the slider, creating a visually balanced starting point. The update slide transforms function manages each slide's position, rotation, and appearance relative to the active slide. It calculates the difference between the current slides and active indexes. Then it applies rotation, translation, and z-index changes to create a layered dynamic effect. The active slide is styled distinctly with no transformations. The navigation buttons are enabled or disabled based on whether the active slide is at the start or end of the list. We set the opacity of the previous and next buttons. It makes them appear dimmed when disabled and fully visible when enabled. We can handle slide navigation by updating the active index to the previous or next slide. After changing the active index, both functions call update slide transforms to adjust the visual positions and styles of the slides. Then, event listeners are added to the previous and next buttons to trigger the functions when the buttons are clicked. We also add mouse wheel navigation to the slider triggered only while hovering. This function listens for the wheel event and uses a scroll timeout to prevent rapid transitions. Depending on the scroll direction, it calls the previous slide for upward scrolling or the next slide for downward scrolling. It ensures smooth navigation with a 400 millisecond delay between slides. Now we will add some CSS properties to highlight the active slide and control buttons. The active slide is highlighted with a soft box shadow to emphasize its position. The overlay becomes visible with a smooth transition when a slide is active. The text is animated with a pop-out effect. The text smoothly transitions upwards while it becomes visible. The color of the control buttons changes by creating a pulsating effect. Also, the scale of their size is between their original size and 1.1 times larger. The disabled buttons, as you can see, remain static without any animations. Finally, we add a background animation with a snowfall effect. I'm using Particles.js to create it. We can reach the template from its GitHub repository. Now we copy the CDN here and paste it into the HTML file. There's a div for the particle effect having the ID Particles.js. We don't use interactivity for this project, so we can delete it. We set the direction to the bottom so that the particles move downwards. I set their sizes to 4, but you can increase or decrease this value. We have 300 circular particles. For style, it's positioned absolutely to cover the background. By the way, I made a mistake in the z-index value. You can fix it like this. And that's it! We've built an interactive and responsive rotating slider with smooth animations. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the bell icon so you never miss out on the latest tutorials. Thanks for watching!